Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Govind Narayan Purohit, and today we will be talking about the instruments in veterinary obstetrics. Friends, frequently instruments are put for your spotting in your UG exams, and also you should know the practical use of the instrument that is available to you. So today we'll be discussing about the instrument. I will show the instrument, its name and its use. Right, I am Professor Govind Narayan Purohit, the former Dean Postgraduate Studies and the former University Head Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Obstetrics, College of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Rajasthan University of Veterinary and Animal Sciences, Bikaner, Rajasthan, India. So friends, if you have already subscribed to my channel, I am highly thankful to you. If you have not already subscribed, kindly do subscribe to it so that you receive the notification of our videos very fast. Right? So let us start. Now, I have classified the instruments used in veterinary obstetrics as those used for pulling or traction on the fetus, and then instruments used for changing the fetal orientation, and then lastly the instruments used for cutting the fetus, or what is known as the fetotomy. Friends, the first and foremost an important instrument which every one of you do have it is your hand. You see, you can use your hand in obstetrics for manipulations during delivery, and the second easily available instrument is the rope. Right, so I'll just show you how you can use your hand for correcting the fetal orientation or correcting the fetal position posture during obstetrical operations. You see, you can use your hand for manual pulling of the fetus. Say in this picture you can see that the hand is being used to correct the deviated head of the fetus, and in this picture the finger of your hand is used to raise the head of the canine fetus. Right, then you can use your hand for manual correction of the fetal posture, as this one, the shoulder flexion. You can see here the shoulder flexion is first converted into a elbow flexion, and then by putting your the hoof of the fetus in your hand, it is then straightened. Then manual correction of the hock flexion. If there is bilateral hock flexion, you can just straighten the hocks to deliver the fetus. So it's in all these pictures you can see it's your hand. Then manual pulling of a cat fetus by grasping it between your fingers, and then manual pulling of pig fetuses by grasping the snout, or grasping the face, or grasping the hind legs between your hand and pulling it out. Now, it's always advisable not to use excessive force. As you can see in this picture, that a person is pulling the fetus by attaching it to a tractor. This is not at all advisable. Don't use excessive force to pull a fetus. This is not advisable. Rather, this one is also not advisable, because an excessive force without correcting the fetal posture can lead to fetal death of the animal, of course the fetus also, and then rupture of the uterus, and the expulsion of the abdominal organs outside the body. Then instruments, first we talk of the instruments used for pulling or the traction on the fetus, and this includes, first of all, we have already discussed your hand, then ropes, obstetrical chains, hooks, and lastly the calf puller. The ropes, the cotton rope, as you can see this one, the cotton ropes are always better because they do not slip. The nylon ropes may sometimes be used, but they always have, they are slippery, and they may also cause abrasion on the fetus, on the uterine wall. Then ropes made of jute are not at all advisable because they can abrade the birth canal, and they can also cause abrasions on your hand. So the cotton ropes are always the best. Cotton ropes, they can be pre-sterilized and kept beforehand for using it during your obstetrical operations. Now, when using a rope, one has to make a loop of the rope. You see, you can make the loops of the rope like this, and then you can just place a wooden thing in between the ropes for pulling it. So this end, you can just pull it like this, and you can have a better grip by putting a wooden stick or a bamboo for pulling the ropes. Then there are different rope carriers available which can carry the rope to the desired place, and these carriers include the various types. This one is the sands pattern. This can also be used as a wire carrier. You can use the carriers for carrying the wire, sometimes the rope, and sometimes even the chains. Say you want to carry this chain and apply it somewhere, and then you have to use this carrier, place it at the desired place and pull it back so that this chain will form a loop around the fetal part which you need to, or which you want to pull. So there are different types of rope carriers. The Lindhorst pattern, it's a small round ring like this one. And then the Shiverer's pattern, it is a heavy stainless steel carrier which carry the rope. You can just tie the rope over here, and then you can place it around the hoof of a calf to pull it. So there are different rope carriers: the sands pattern, the Shiverer's pattern, and the Lindhorst pattern. Now the rope chain carriers, this rope carriers can be also be used for carrying a chain inside, so that you can place the chain at the appropriate place and then pull the fetus. So like this, you can pass it, and then you pass it, as you can see in the picture, this rope carrier is passed around the fetal leg, and then this will be pulled back, and then the leg will be pulled. Then while applying the ropes on the head, it's advisable to apply it between the lips and behind the ears. So make a loop of it, apply it behind the ears, and then tie it between the lips in the mouth, so that if you apply it on the lower lip, then that may break and that may cause injury to the live fetus. Then leg snares are available for pulling the lambs. They are made of rope, and then rope can be applied on the legs, and you can just pull the fetus or pull the leg of the fetus to you can make a loop like this, put it on the leg of the fetus, and then you can tighten this end, and this will tighten, and then you can pull the leg of the fetus, right? Then rope placement on the legs, it's always better to place ropes separately on both the legs, and then you pull the fetus. It's not advisable to pull the fetus until unless the head is resting on the knees in the anterior longitudinal presentation. And rope placement like this on the lower jaw is not advisable, because a calf's lower jaw would be very soft and it may break. So if the fetus is live, then this can cause serious injury to the fetus, which will be difficult to repair, right? Then the head snares are available. These head snares can be placed similar to ropes, and the headhunter calf snare is also available. This is a headhunter calf snare. You just place it on the head of the fetus and then you pull the snare, and the fetus fetal head will be straightened. Then the snares carrying a stainless steel chain is also available. You can put it around the mouth, you can put it behind the ears and tighten it in the mouth by pushing this end, and then tying a rope on this end, you can just pull the fetus, right? Then snares are available. This is a plastic tubular snare which is available for sheep, and this one is a wire snare which is used for pigs. You can see here the snare is put on the snout upper part, and then this piglet can be pulled, or maybe this is placed behind the ears and then the piglet is pulled outside. So all these instruments are used for traction, applying force to pull the fetus, right? Then obstetric chains are made up of stainless steel are always better. You can sterilize them and you can use them for pulling the fetus. The one end of the chain is applied curving chain handle, and these are of two types. The Moore's pattern, as these are the Moore's pattern curving chain handles, and then there is a T type or the Gibbons pattern curving chain handle. So obstetric chains are used for traction on the fetus, for pulling it outside, right? Now chain application can be done similar to the rope application, and you can make a loop of the chain and then place it on the face, guide it through your hand, place it behind the ears, and then you can pull the face of the or the head of the fetus, right? Now this is the right approach to apply a chain on the leg. If you so this is the right approach to apply a chain on the leg, and this is not the right approach, because then because of excessive pressure of the chain on this joint may separate out. You can see in these pictures on both the legs the chains have been applied and they are being pulled by the Moore's obstetric handle, chain handle. So this is the Moore's obstetric chain handle, and this is the Gibbons pattern or the T handle for pulling the obstetric chains. Then a very useful instrument for the obstetrician is the Williams long blunt hook. This long blunt hook is made up of stainless steel, and you can carry it. It has a screw over here, so you can tighten it and then you can place it inside to catch hold or to apply on the part of the fetus where you want to apply mostly. Then there is the Brontë hook. The Williams long blunt hook is useful when applying on the inner canthus of the eye, especially if the fetus is dead. You can use it, you can just go to reach the head in the orbit of the eye, you can apply it, and then you can apply a rope on this end and then pull it. So this is the long blunt hook. Two types of William long blunt hooks are available. One is for cutting, which has a sharp edge over here, and that is used for cutting the ribs, right? So the long blunt hook can be used for pulling the fetus or correcting the fetal orientation. But the long blunt hook and the sharp small eye hooks, there are this one, as you can see, this one sharp small eye hooks, they are difficult to be used in a live fetus because then they can injure the eyeball, right? So it's always useful to use the blunt hooks, and then with these small hooks you can apply a rope and then place it, take it inside and place it on the inner canthus of the eye, and then you can pull, you can apply a pull which will just straighten the head of the fetus. It's always important in obstetrics that when you are using these instruments, then the birth canal should be sufficiently dilated and there should be sufficient lubrication. These two things are very important, because otherwise the ends of the instruments can tear the birth canal or may tear other places. So you should have sufficient room for working. Then there are the small eye hooks, as this one. Different names have been given, the small sharp small hook, or the Easter tag, and the Ham's pattern, and then the blunt hooks, the Freiberger pattern, and a wide variety of other patterns are available. So these are the small hooks, and these are placed on the eyes. Placing the hook inside the jaw is not available because it will tear the jaw and it will come out. It's always better to use two hooks. You place two hooks and place them on both the eyes like this, and then pull them together. Especially using a blunt hook is advisable for live fetuses. Then there is the double eye hook or the sister hook. You can again pass the rope over here, take it inside. It's essential that you place rope over here, otherwise the instrument may fall inside the uterus. Suppose it slips from your hand. So it's always better to apply a rope on these ends, and it has got double eye hook or the sister hook, what is it is known as. It is also made up of stainless steel and applied on the inner canthus of the eye of the fetus to pull it outside. Here you can see the small hook is taken near the eye, and then it's applied in the inner canthus of the eye. Now you can see the two hooks, two small blunt eye hooks. They are a rope is passed through them, and then both are applied on the inner canthus of the eye. And this, when they are sufficiently applied, then this end is pulled to pull the fetus. Improved new hooks for placement over fetal eyes are now available. As you can see, this one, it has ends which are not at all sharp, and so they will cause minimum harm to the eye of the fetus. You can see both the hooks have been, this hook has been placed on the eye, and then centrally the rope is applied and the hook is pulled outside. You can see like this, it's placed and this rope is pulled, and these two ropes are applied on the legs of the fetus to pull it outside. Then there are other hooks, the Obermeyer's anal hook. This is placed in the anus of the fetus if the fetus is in posterior presentation. And then there is the Kreis-Kottler hook. You can see this Kreis-Kottler hook, it has got action like this. And when again you have to tie a rope over here, and then when you press it from this side, then it will, the jaws of the hook are very sharp. They will get deeper into the tissues of the fetus, and then they will have anchorage. So this type of hook would be useful. You see, during fetotomy, or if the part of the fetus is broken, you can see here the Kreis-Kottler hook has been applied on the part that is broken, because now you don't have any place to pull. So the Kreis-Kottler hook is applied like this, and this goes deeper inside, and now you can pull the part of the fetus, right? Then there is the calf puller or the calf jack. Now this has two ends which are applied to the legs of the fetus, and then there is the lever system over here When you press this lever, the jack, it moves towards this direction. And when it moves towards this direction, it pulls the fetus, which is tied to the two cuffs of the calf puller or the calf jack. Now, it is always mentioned that producers or vets should never touch the calf puller until they can meet the rule of three. And what is the rule of three? Both shoulders and the head of the calf, the three things, must be delivered into the pelvis by hand before they touch the calf jack. So, if the two legs and the head, two shoulders and the head of the calf, the three things are in the pelvis, then you can apply a jack to pull the fetus. Otherwise, you do not use this jack or the calf puller, right? Then there are traction instruments for the bitch. As you can see here, during the delivery, the bitch is delivering. And what one can do is, one can only pass his fingers inside the small birth canal of the bitch. So, there are a very limited number of instruments available for obstetrical corrections in the bitch. And these are the forceps. The forceps like this one is less useful because it will slip. These ends are straight, but this Ph.D's whelping forceps, it is curved on one end. So this type of forceps is very useful for whelping of the bitch. And if the fetus is inside the pelvis, you can grasp the fetus and pull it outside. Then applying traction on the bitch fetuses, you have to guide with your finger. And if the fetus is live, it's always advisable to use some lubrication and to use the instruments very judiciously, especially the whelping forceps, because they can injure the fetal eyes, they can injure the fetal ears, and so one must be careful. Then the snare and the forceps, this is a snare which has been passed on the head of the fetus, and then you can pull it with the forceps, the pup will come out, because the pups, they have very small extremities, so they will not create much difficulty if a proper pull is applied on the head in the anterior presentation, right? Then there is a vectus. This is a vectus, stainless steel, and a vectus, you can see, you just a fetal head is downside, you can move it upside by your finger and applying a pressure by the vectus on the head and placing another finger on the jaw, you can just pull the fetus, right? Then traction instruments for the sow, there are the pharynx forceps. A pharynx forceps like this one, it is straight, so it's less useful, and this is sometimes used for the bitch also, but it, because it is straight, it is not curved at this end. So say if the fetal head is here and you push it, pull it, then it can slip. So the forceps having a curved end like this one are more useful for farrowing. Then the wire hook, this is a wire hook which can be applied on the eyes or of the piglet to apply traction. Then we come to the instruments used for cutting parts of the fetus, what we known as phytotomy. Phytotomy is a technique of fetal delivery where we cut parts of the fetus for its vaginal delivery, so that sufficient room is created and the fetus can be easily taken out. There are a lot of advantages of the phytotomy and there are a lot of disadvantages if it is done ruthlessly. Right now, for there are two types of phytotomies. One is the subcutaneous phytotomy. Subcutaneous phytotomy is where we cut or incise the skin of the fetus, and then underneath the skin we incise, go on incising, and then break the muscles and tissues, and then pull that part so that it breaks and comes out. There are we need to use some knives for subcutaneous phytotomy, and there are three types of knives: the Stahlfors pattern knife, this one. This has a end which can you can just guide it with your hand, take it inside and cut the skin. Then there are the Linde ring knife, which has a single ring and it has a hooked sharp point over here. Then there is the Gunther ring knife, which has two rings. You can place your finger inside, guide it through your finger to cut the parts of the skin. So there are three types of knives: the Stahlfors pattern, the Linde ring knife having a single ring, and then the Gunther ring knife having two rings on the knife, right? So this is how we take the knife and then cut, say if we want to remove this limb, because we want to create space in the birth canal, so we need to remove this limb. So we cut the parts of the skin and then separate the underlying structures and break all the underlying structures so that the limb is separated out from the scapula and it comes out. So now you get room for further correction inside the birth canal, right? Then instruments used for cutting parts of the fetus completely, what is known as the percutaneous fetotomy. There are three types of fetotomes, or previously they were also known as the embryotomes, but fetotome is a better term, because we are not cutting the embryo but we are cutting the fetus. Three types of fetotomes are available: a single barrel from outside, we have the two fetotomes, the Benesch or the Neubauer's fetotome, which has a head over here, and then on this end you will see that there are two barrels separately. And then there is the uteract fetotome. This one, it's very commonly used, the uteract fetotome, because of its easy handling and because of the robustness of the instrument. Then there is the Thygesen's fetotome. This is the Thygesen's fetotome. You can just close both the ends, and then there is a screw. You can just close this screw so that now this fetotome parts will not come out. If you want to separate them out, then again you open the screw and you can take out the parts of the fetotome. The fetotomes, they work with the giggly wire saw. This is the wire saw. It is a serrated wire, and this wire is passed through this fetotome. There is a wire saw threader. You can see this one. This is a threader, and this threader is passed through one of the point, and I will show you how it is being passed. And then this fetotome and all the other two fetotomes, it's also known as the Danish fetotome, and these are used for cutting parts of the fetus, right, for fetotomy. Now this is the wire saw threader, and this is the Hoppner wire saw introducer. You can also use the Hoppner, or you can use the Sands pattern wire introducer also. You tie the wire over here and then place it around the part you want to place it, take it out back and place both the ends in the fetotome, pass both the ends in the fetotome. So and then the wires are taken out from the handle side, both the sides the wire will come, and then we will have to tie these wires to the wire handles. You place the wire inside, say this is one type of handle, this is another type of handle. You can see you have one can pass the wire saw through these handles, and there is a screw. There are different types of wire saws, and you can just, when you just tighten the screw, now this wire will not come out, and when we make a sawing action like this, the part of the fetus will be cut. Then you can use the Hoppner wire saw introducer, or you can use any the chivalrous pattern or the Sands pattern or the Lindhorst pattern wire saw, or the rope introducer inside, and then you can do the obstetric work. So this is how the wire saw is threaded. The wire saw threader is passed through one end and then wire is attached over here. It's pulled back and the wire comes out. It's passed, then passed through the other tube, and then the other end of the wire is threaded to this wire saw again. It's pulled again, and so a loop of wire is formed over here, right? So the thyrosine foetotome is used for percutaneous foetotomy, when you want to cut the part of the fetus along with the skin. Then there are different types of wire saw handles. Say this is the Poulsen pattern. You can just tie the wire over here, and then when you tighten the screw, then this wire will remain here, and you can make a grip on in your hand and then make a sawing action like this, and the wire will work like a saw and it will cut the part. Then there is the thyrosine pattern. As you have seen, there is a hole inside, and when we tighten this screw, then the wire would not come out. Now if you just pull it, it will not come out of the wire saw handle. Then there is a bolt pattern. You place the wire here and then you tighten the screw, so this is like a ball and you can use it for the sawing action. The Poulsen pattern is much more safer because your hand is not touching the wire saw. And the thyrosine, maybe sometimes you are holding like this and the wire slips, it can cut your finger. Same is with the ball pattern. So this one is much more safer than the other two types, right? Then there is the list wire saw. There is a just foldable. You place the wire in between, and then the wire you just tighten it, and this can also be used for the sawing action. Then there is the Goetze pattern wire saw holder, but the list wire saw handle and the Poulsen pattern are much better over the other two, because if accidentally the wire slips, it can injure the obstetrician's hand. Then there is the giggly wire saw. You can see this is the giggly wire saw. This one also, you can see there are serrations, and these serrations, when they just continuously rub on the tissues, they cut the tissues including the bones also. So they are useful for the foetotomy, for the percutaneous foetotomy. So this is again the giggly wire saw. Then using the foetotome, you can perform a decapitation. You first tie the legs of the fetus with a chain and then pass this foetotome around the neck, and you just apply pressure on the near the shoulders, and by a sawing action you can just cut the head. You can cut the other parts, detruncation also, and then for limb removal, you can just place the wire saw here, and by sawing action you can just cut the limb, and then you can take out this limb manually, and for pulling the fetus again, then you can use a Kreis Kotler hook for applying traction on that part which is exposed, and when this pressure is applied here, this makes a grip on the soft tissues and embeds inside, and then you can pull the fetus. Then it can be used for pelvic bisection. Then we talk of the instruments used for changing the fetal orientation. Now there are some instruments which are used to change the fetal orientation, and the one is the Kunz crutch repeller. This is the Kunz crutch repeller. There are two ends through which you can pass the ropes, and you can tie these ropes to the leg of the fetus. And then previously there were a lot many other types of the repeller, the William crutch repeller and the Roberts crutch repeller, and many other types were used in the past. Then for changing the fetal orientation, we have the retorsion rod and the camera's torsion fork. This is the camera's torsion fork. On these two cups, you can apply the cuffs. These are the cuffs, and these cuffs are applied to the legs of the fetus. And then there is a handle over here, and this handle is just tighten it, or on this end you can apply a wooden handle also. If this is not a wooden handle, then you can use a wooden handle to rotate it, right? And then there is the detorsion rod. To this detorsion rod, the legs of the fetuses are tied separately, one on this side, another on this side, and then you pass a through this end you can pass a another handle, or and then you can rotate it like this. So these are used for correcting the orientation of the fetus during uterine torsion, and for correcting the fetal orientation at other times also. So this is how the camera's torsion fork, the cuffs are placed on the legs, and then when you rotate it with your hand, then the fetal orientation is likely to change, right? Then there are reports of a new instrument which has been given the name the gyn stick or the gyn stick, whatever you call it. And this is used for a variety of purposes, for detorsion of the fetus, for pulling the fetal legs of the fetus, and hopefully this instrument will be available at a very appropriate cost, so it will be very useful for use in the field, at the field level, right? Then for episiotomy, what you need is a scalpel. You need to cut the vulvar lips from this end, and then after cutting it, you need to suture them. So you need a scalpel, and you need suture materials to suture the vulvar lips, part of the vulvar lips, if the fetal head is causing problem and the vulva is not sufficiently dilated or it is smaller, then you can just make incise it with a scalpel, and then you can suture the parts, right? So hopefully you like this lecture. This is my email. You can contact me at my email gnpobs@gmail.com, and this is my YouTube channel link. You can contact me at my email, at my LinkedIn, and then if you really like this video lecture, kindly give your likes, kindly share the video, give your comments, give your suggestions. And if you really like it, then kindly share and subscribe to my channel Govind Narayan Purohit. So hopefully we will be coming with more and more videos for you, and hopefully they will be useful for you, right? Okay, then bye bye, have a nice day, bye bye.